Welcome back. Last time we saw how to automate mundane and repetitive work by using Power Automate. Earlier we downloaded an Amazon report by recording the steps. If you have not seen the video, have a look at it first. In this video, we are going to recreate this automation, but the difference is instead of recording our steps, we are going to create all these steps manually. What is the benefit of that? You will learn Power Automate better. And second, sometimes the recording approach doesn't work. So in real life, you'll have to use a combination of manual steps and recorded steps. So let's recreate this flow from scratch. I'm going to close this, create a blank new flow. We already know the process, but just to recap, these are the steps we want to perform. Now this time we have to understand these actions because we are going to add one action at a time. There are lots of things it can work with. Currently we are interested in the browser part. When you open this section, you'll see a lot of actions, but for now we just want to launch a browser. I'm going to use Chrome. You can use Edge or Firefox as well. Do not use Internet Explorer. It's only for backward compatibility, but it's very dangerous to use Internet Explorer in today's world. Let's specify the URL. Because we are doing this manually, it allows me to decide is it in regular shape or size or maximized or minimized. Doesn't really matter, but because it's a demo, I'm going to choose maximized. Now this browser can be referred to later because we are going to put many steps. Eventually we have to close the browser. Sometimes we may have opened two browsers. How do you know which one to close? So each one is given a name. And just to show you what the name is, by default it is browser. I will call it Amazon browser. Let's run this because we want to open the browser. The browser is going to open maximized. Now, next step is I usually hover the mouse here and then go to business analytics. Now, hover are ambiguous things. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. So I'm going to explicitly say hover here and then go here by adding a step directly. So come back and search for hover. Hover mouse over something on the web page. Says OK, which browser? Amazon browser. Now it's asking me where is the UI element? I have to show that. That's called add UI element. The moment you click on that, this whole window will disappear and a small window will come. This is telling me you choose whatever you want, and when you are happy with it, control click means press the control key and then click on it. OK, that's what I did. Mouse to hover. OK, might as well. What does this do? Whether to physically move the mouse to cursor over the element. This is a good idea. Now sometimes the emulated one doesn't. Save. I'm going to add another action where I want to click on that business analytics button. So search for click. Click on some link. Now where is that link? Again, you have to identify the UI element. You know the story. Add UI element. That window has appeared, but I have two monitors, so it is on the other monitor. You already know about it, so I'm not going to take the trouble of bringing that window again and again here. So what do I want to do? Go here and I want to identify the link on which I want to click. I'm not clicking. I'm pressing control and click. Yes. Now click save. So if we save this and run only this flow, what will happen now? Let's see. The browser is still running, so I'm going to manually close the browser and test this. At the end of it, what should happen? It should go to the business analytics page and stop. Let's see. Run. Open the browser. Maximize. Hover. Click on that button. Business analytics. Excellent. And now it stays on this page. So let's keep the browser open because we want to do the next step. Next is to click on the orders button. But again, look at what happens here. I'm not clicking. This is a hover and then this is the click. This is not click and click because if I click here, nothing happens. Now we have just created a hover and click. So let's copy this. Select Control C, copy, Control V, paste. And we will just change the elements. This is the hover on the earlier menu. This time I will say add UI element and hover on report. Important to make sure that the correct element is having that red border and then control click. Save. And the next one again, add element. What is the element this time? This one, control click, save. After clicking on the orders button, we need to click on the generate report button. So let's come back here and copy paste the same orders click action. Only thing we need to change is the UI element, control click on generate report, save and run. Your browser is still open, so I'm going to close it so that we can start from scratch. And let's see how it performs. While it is rerunning the flow, you should observe it carefully so that you can understand mistakes, if any. So far it is OK, but now I tried to click on the generate button a little too quickly. So the button was still loading or something like that. So let's put a delay before this step. So I'm going to close this. And delay is called wait. Wait, you can put any delay, but I'm going to put 5 seconds right now. Wait for process. Just wait for 5 seconds. Save. And this should be before clicking on the generate report button. Again, save and run. Now it's going to pause for 5 seconds. Do nothing. And then you will see the generate report button being clicked. And it seems to work perfectly. The exact number of seconds you'll have to figure out. Now, how do we know the report is generated? Right now it's taking whatever time you're seeing, but if there are more transactions, it may take longer. So again, we can put a delay if required. Or there is a better option. When the generate report is done, a new piece of text came. Your report download is now available. So we now don't have to wait for arbitrary number of seconds, and we can ask the system to wait till this text appears. That sounds like a more precise way of handling automation. I want to copy this text and come back. Now here, the next step is we want to close the browser. Let's put that action anyway, and it already knows Amazon browser, but not immediately after generating the report. You have to wait for something. If you go to the browser section, there's a brilliant option. Wait for web page content. And what content? Well, there are many options. Contains a particular element like a button or a text box or a drop down. We could use that, but there is an even better option. Before we clicked on generate report, the download is ready. Text was not there on the web page. After the report is ready, that text came. I'm saying wait for the web page till the web page contains this text. Excellent. So let's say save. And now click on the generate button. Wait for a download to be ready. Download will happen automatically because that is configured to go into my download folder. And then close the browser. So let's save this. The browser is still open, so let's close that. Let's go to the downloads folder and delete. And now let's run the flow. There's a 5 second delay here. Now we'll see as soon as the green text appears, the browser will close. Perfect. Now this is how you manually create a flow. Once this is created, on a day-to-day basis, how do you run it? You just go to the home page. This is the one we just recorded. We are going to run it from here. And it shows you a flow monitoring window, which shows you the steps. And when all the steps are done, you're good to go. So we got an error in step 7, which is the generate report button click. But if you look at the browser, it has just stopped at report stage. That means hover on report and go to order didn't happen at all. So to be on the safer side, I have put 3 delays. Before and after order. And after generate report is finished, because for that download file to happen also takes little while. Before we run the report, there's some setting which you need to change. When it is running from here, it shows you that flow monitoring window which we just saw. But sometimes that hover thing gets disturbed because of the window. I'm saying show me Windows notifications. Don't show me that monitoring window. And after this, let's run the flow. I'm going to fast forward it so that you don't have to wait for the whole thing to run. So far, so good. Reports. After that 5 second delay, then it'll click on orders. And again 5 second delay, and then click on generate report. There you have it. The file is downloaded and now the browser will close. That's it. Try this out in your environment on your apps and let me know if you like it. And mind you, Power Automate is just one of the 25 apps available in Microsoft 365. I help organizations maximize the efficiency by working on all these tools in the right way. So if you are interested, do send me a mail. I'll be happy to work with your organization. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.